Assalamu alaikum. Good morning. My name is Raja Salim Akhtar. Welcome in this new video. Before to watch the further video, subscribe my channel, like the video, click on bell icon, share the videos. Examples of bounded linear operators and hence a continuous linear operators. Example 1. Let N and M be normed spaces show that the zero operator denoted by the element 0 from normed space N to normed space M defined by zero of x is equal to 0 for all x belongs to normed space N is bounded and hence a continuous linear operator. Solution. Here norm of zero operator equal to supremum norm of zero operator of x over x norm where x is not equal to 0 and x belongs to norm space N. It can be written as supremum 0 of x is equal to 0 for the zero operator. So 0 norm over x norm where x is not equal to 0 and x belongs to N. It can be written as 0 norm equal to 0, 0 over x norm equal to 0. So supremum x is not equal to 0, x belongs to N and this is equal to 0. This implies norm of 0 operator is finite. The zero operator is bounded and hence a continuous linear operator because we know that linear operator T is continuous on N if and only if T is bounded. Hence the solution. Example 2. Let N be a normed space show that the identity operator I from norm space N to norm space N defined by I of x is equal to x for all x belongs to N is bounded and hence a continuous linear operator. Solution. here norm of identity operator I equal to supremum I of x norm over x norm, where x is not equal to 0 and x belongs to norm space N. It can be written as supremum I of x is equal to x. So x norm over x norm, x is not equal to 0 and x belongs to N. It can be written as supremum x is not equal to 0 and x belongs to N 1. This is equal to 1. This implies norm of identity operator is finite, and we know that the identity operator I is bounded, and hence a continuous linear operator, because linear operator T is continuous if and only if linear operator T is bounded. Hence the solution, example 3, let m dimensional and n dimensional be normed spaces, show that the operator A from Rm to Rn given by y is equal to Ax equal to sigma j from 1 to n into sigma I from 1 to m Aij xi into e dash j, where x is equal to x1 comma x2 so on comma xn, and y is equal to y1 comma y2 so on comma yn, and the set e1 comma e2 so on comma em, and the set e dash 1 comma e dash 2 comma so on e dash n are bases in m dimensional normed space and n dimensional normed space Rn respectively is bounded, and hence a continuous linear operator. Solution, here yj is equal to sigma I from 1 to m aij xi, note it, therefore ax norm square equal to y norm square, and it is equal to sigma j from 1 to n yj square and it can be written as sigma j from 1 to n yj, sigma I from 1 to m aij xi magnitude square, it can be written as by Minkowski's inequality less than equal to sigma j from 1 to n sigma I from 1 to m aij magnitude square into sigma I from 1 to m xi magnitude square, note it, it can be written as less than equal to sigma j from 1 to n sigma I from 1 to m aij magnitude square into sigma I from 1 to m xi magnitude square, and it can be written as less than equal to k square x norm square, where k square is equal to sigma j from 1 to n sigma I from 1 to m aij magnitude square, or k is equal to all this one under root, and x norm square is equal to sigma I from 1 to m xi square, or x norm is equal to under root. Hence, Ax norm can be written as less than equal to k times x norm, taking square root of both sides. This implies, according to definition of bounded linear operator, A is bounded, and hence a continuous linear operator, because we know that T is continuous if and only if T is bounded. We put A norm is equal to sigma j from 1 to n sigma I from 1 to m aij magnitude square under root, and is called the norm of the matrix operator A. Hence the solution. Example 4. Prove that every linear operator on a finite dimensional normed space is bounded, and hence a continuous linear operator. Proof or solution. Let n be a finite dimensional normed space and M be a norm space. Let T from norm space N to norm space M be a linear operator. Let B is equal to set consisting on E1, comma E2, so on, comma EN be a basis of norm space N. So this set is linearly independent, and B, this set spawns N. Therefore, for any X belongs to N, we can write X is equal to sigma I from 1 to N Xi Ei, because B spawns N. So this implies Tx norm is equal to T sigma I from 1 to N Xi Ei norm and it can be written as sigma I from 1 to N Xi Tei norm because T is linear and it can be written as less than equal to sigma I from 1 to N Xi magnitude Tei norm by generalized triangle inequality, and it can be written as less than equal to B sigma I from 1 to N Xi magnitude inequality 1, where B is equal to supremum or maximum I from 1 to N Tei norm, note it also by lemma, there is a positive real number C such that X norm equal to sigma I from 1 to N X is equal to sigma I from 1 to N Xi Ei norm can be written as by lemma C times sigma I from 1 to N Xi magnitude, because by lemma if B is independent sigma I from 1 to N Ei Xi norm greater than equal to C times sigma I from 1 to N Ei magnitude, already proved, it can be written as sigma I from 1 to N Xi magnitude less than equal to 1 over C times X norm. Hence inequality 1 can be written as T X norm less than equal to B into 1 over C X norm, note it, it can be written as T X norm less than equal to b over c x norm, or it can be written as t x norm less than equal to k times x norm, where k is equal to b over c. Therefore, according to this, hence t is bounded and so is a continuous linear operator, because t is continuous on norm space N if and only if t is bounded. Hence the solution.